In this video, you'll see how to query third-party data with Amazon Redshift Serverless. With this solution, you can subscribe to Redshift data share-based products from AWS Data Exchange, create a Redshift Serverless workgroup and database, and then run queries on the database using the Redshift Query Editor. We'll start in AWS Data Exchange and navigate to the third-party data product we'll be using. For the purposes of this demonstration, we have subscribed to this free ESG GC score sample. Let's quickly note our AWS region. Let's take a look at what the sample contains. We have an Amazon Simple Storage Service, or Amazon S3 object, and an Amazon Redshift data share. Let's go to Amazon Redshift Serverless to create a workgroup for the data share. Amazon Redshift Serverless is a serverless option of Amazon Redshift that makes it easy to run and scale analytics in seconds, without the need to set up and manage data warehouse infrastructure. We'll name the workgroup Default and proceed to the next step. We'll also use Default as the name of the namespace. Let's create an AWS Identity and Access Management, or IAM, role that will grant the necessary permissions. We'll create this role as the default for this configuration. Let's review the configuration and create the workgroup. This will take a few minutes to create. Let's skip ahead to when the workgroup is ready and take a look at our DataShare subscription. This tab lists all the AWS Data Exchange data shares we're currently subscribed to. In this case, we're only subscribed to the ESG GC score sample. Next, we'll create a database from this data share so we can run queries on it. Let's use the default namespace and workgroup we created earlier. We'll then name the database and create it. Now that the database has been created, let's go to the serverless dashboard. We'll select Query Data to open the Redshift Query Editor. Next, we'll create a connection to the serverless workgroup we created. Here's the database we created. Let's drill down. If we select the table, we can view its data fields and types here. Let's try running a query. Let's run a sample query. Here's the third-party data that our query has returned. Let's run a more meaningful query. You've just seen how to query third-party data from AWS Data Exchange with Amazon Redshift Serverless. You can learn more about this topic in the description and links for this video. Thanks for watching. Now it's your turn to try.